hanging on the lead.
Cam and Dodie and Christina. I'm supposed to be helping them, but
no, you know, you're doing okay. You're doing. Wait, I'm gonna put that in here.
Edna.
Yes, Miss Edna on the scene.
All right. Hey, honey.
Nice to have you on the scene, Miss Edna.
And there's Chucky Luck.
Chucky Luck, she's talking to you.
Chelsea.
Right here. There's Miss Chelsea.
Hi, Chelsea.
Hey, Auntie.
There's my Becky and Chuck
there.
There's Ann and Pam. Mother and daughter.
We got here at about 5.
There's Pam's husband. You ain't camera.
You're here, sis.
There's mom, there's David.
Hi.
Hi, David.
Hi. Hi, very good to see you. Happy, happy time.
Yeah.
All right.
Christina.
Wow.
There's Pam's husband. There's Aunt Julia. There's Frankie's son. There's Guy. There's Uncle Roy. There's Aunt Anna and Uncle Wiley.
Okay, so there you go. Put it on. Do it.
Once you come out with the ice bucket out
there. Ooh, I'm sorry.
And I just Christina. Hey, I see you over there.
Say hi.
Hi. Yeah, she got your package over.
I see you.
What did you do with the shirts?
Hi.
I gave one to Mom, I gave one to myself, and I gave one to Natalie.
And here's yours.
Say hello.
Everybody. This is one of the best things that ever happened.
You're beautiful.
There's Andrea. Hi, Natalie.
Hi, Mom.
Novella's not out here. She must be in the house.
Right.
Yeah.
Oh,
today.
Say something, someone.
I don't know why that.
Lillian? Oh,
that box won't play tapes over there. If you give me a knife, I go back and put a spot for it. Make me a tape player out of it.
Come on, Lillian. Come on, Judy.
Hey, Jennifer. Do your thing, girl.
Breakfast and lunch for two near the hotel.
Oh, yeah. Stay well.
Hi, Natalie, what happened?
That's okay. No, that's okay. Just want to get everybody in here.
Can you breathe out there?
Yeah, cool. Stop the table. Good.
Here we are at the White family party at Granny's house. Here comes Miss Natalie.
Natalie, come on. Don't run.
There's the chef. And they're serving dinner. It's a very hot day here in Chicago. But nonetheless, it's beautiful because all the family is here. So we're going to take a little walk in the inside. And we're going to see what everybody's eating on. Here comes Guy and Natalie.
Say something.
Here.
And may the all that bond of love continue. We appreciate, but most of us seniors, there's a lot of good rap out there. The young people are doing some religious raps, and they're doing a lot of raps that are good, and you know about all the other stuff, so I don't have to bother with that. But most of us, I have pretty good hearing, and for the life of me, I never could understand what the and get the messages that the young people were bringing out. And rapping is all about message sending. So I've written about maybe 50 or 60 different raps, and I perform them throughout the valley in Arizona. And I get paid for it, too, and pretty well. And I do a lot just for fun. So I'm going to do the first rap that I wrote that I call the senior rap, and I'm not doing the thing that Royal mentioned for the family, because I didn't bring my copier along with me. It's at the house, and I didn't memorize it. But I'm going to do my senior rap for you, which is all about senior life, and I'm sure all of the seniors can identify with it, and the younger people will have to say, oh, that's my. And then I'm going to do one that you can participate in with me. It's a religious rap. I'll do that. We were prepared to that rock and roll and rap. In my day, we had soul and death. So let's not widen the generation gap. How about having some senior rap? Hey, hey, what you say? I am the senior rapper coming through, bringing a message just for you. So sit back and put your hand in your lap and get ready to hear some senior rap. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Well, you can do better than that. Let me hear it.
Yeah.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
All right, then. I'm a senior citizen, and I'm proud to say that I'm one of millions in the USA. We come in all sizes, shapes, and colors, too, and we paid our dues for the red, white, and blue. Sometimes we feel that we're being abused, but we're hanging in there because we paid our dues. Some people think we're in the way, but we don't care because we're here to stay. Hey! Did you hear what I say? We paid our dues. We have all kinds of problems, most related to health. Some of us are poor, and some have wealth. We have the AARP that gives us a voice and clout, you see. We have health care provided by the FHP, and we draw our Social Security. We paid our dues. Now, some of us have sex, just like before, and some say they don't need it anymore. Some remember when they could, and some don't think that they should. Some remember how it was fun, and others have forgotten how it's done. But whatever the case may be, sex is safe for us, you see. We like to have our grandchildren present with us, so we can spoil them and make them fuss. We know our nerves will get the strain, and when we get enough, we put them on a plane. Hey, hey, what you say? Now, some of us are having the time of our life, doing hundreds of things, both husbands and wives. We have senior sports competition, too, and you'd be surprised how well we do. Hey! It's golden, baby. We paid our dues. On Sundays, we go to the church of our choice, and we praise God as we rejoice. We lift our voice in song and prayer, along with others who gather there. We give our time and our money, too, so our church can carry its program through. And when it comes to giving, we're still paying our dues, giving back to God what he allows us to use. So when you hear people putting seniors down, stop and take a look around. And while you're looking, don't feel sad, because being a senior citizen ain't that bad. In the game of life, whether you win or lose, You're going to have to pay your dues.
Hey!
We pay our dues. Is Jesus and he reigns supreme. He's the Son of God.
He declared him king and gave him the power to rule the earth, to see that everything had some worth. He came into the world to save us from sin so that we can start life over again. He died on the cross for the cruel fate so that we could start over with a clean slate.
Amen. Amen. Everybody say amen.
He suffered and died all alone. He rose and went to heaven, put on his throne, beside God his Father and our Father too, so that he could watch over me and you. He loves us dearly and he's there every day. He walks with us and talks with us along life's way. He sees all we do and hears all we say. He's with us while we sleep, work and pray. Before we get to heaven, I take my troubles and leave them with him too, for he will surely see you through.
Amen. Amen. Everybody say amen.
He doesn't always do what you ask him to, but he does what he knows is best for you. Sometimes things happen that you don't want to face, and you think you've fallen from his grace. And then you realize that's not true, because of the promise that he gave to you. Once you want to go to heaven, get your reward, you got to do
it. Now, we didn't know our grandmother's last name until just a few days ago when I was in Paducah. And I asked Julia, and see how you communicate. She said her name was Marshall. So now, Julia Marshall married Andrew Wiley in, I don't know what year, but from that marriage there was Lily White born, and Lily White married Arthur White, and that was our grandmother and grandfather, and from that union was born Andrew Wiley White.